looky here. Good evening to you. Good evening, good evening, good evening to you. That I'm working on my radio voice. So glad to be here. Wow. Duh. Yes, this is great. This is great. Thank you for coming. We promised that what we promised is what you are about to hear is designed for your ears and your ears only. The notes that we are about to play have not been played before. We haven't played them now, and most likely will never be played afterward. We thrive on improvisation, spontaneous composition. And so, that's that kind of thing. Sometimes the academic side starts kicking in. I have to explain everything that's happening, you know. But we mostly we hope that it is our intention to send you away feeling better than when you arrived. If we fail, don't sue us. It's a pleasure. Wow, this wow, to be among friends. We had a great fellowship coming from South, right? Charlotte is South? That's South?
Southwest.
Okay, I gotta get my stuff together. And so, ladies and gentlemen, we've been trying to come together on the bandstand for a few days, so to speak. A great titan of the music. You probably heard him with Kenny Garrett, and there's so many more that I could probably spend most of the evening talking about, but you don't want me to do that. But ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the bandstand, Mr. Corcoran Holt. Technology is something, boy. You know, all before you had to write a letter and put a postage stamp on it and send it and hope when it gets to his destination, somebody would pull it up and actually open it up, you know? Now we just send texts or instant messages, Facebook, Instagram, whatever. I was reminded that myself and Stephen, we were on the bandstand together in New Orleans for the WWOZ piano explosion. Remember, that was Ellis was kind of being honored. Ellis, the great Ellis Marsalis, was being honored and was invited to. I'm talking too much. You know, inquiring minds want to know sometime, you know. Anyway, it's great to finally come back to the bandstand. Ladies and gentlemen on drums, Mr. Stephen Gordon. Enough talking. Let's get to some music.
Thank you. like I'm looking, what time is it? I'm trying to figure out what's next, that's all.
How long have y'all been playing together? 30 minutes, 45 minutes.
Yeah, minutes.
45 minutes. And it's the truth, too. It really is the truth. Some people say, well, how can you do it like that? Well, gratefully, we kind of speak the same language. We kind of understand the concept, although I've been throwing them curveballs like left and right. That's what I was saying earlier about, you know, it's in the moment. So what you're hearing now is for you and no one else. Trust me on that. You just heard the blues bags groove. You can, you know, sometimes you just need to throw blues in, you know. Sometimes you just have to play the blues. Yes. Before that, we did an interpretation, I will say interpretation, of a composition by the composer Lionel Richie. We did not intend to play it in the Lionel Richie way. You didn't want us to do that. Now, let's see. There was something else in there that I started out with. You might wonder, how you think of that? Well, I first learned Stairway to Heaven on guitar in the ninth grade in guitar class. And, you know, between playing Smoke on the Water, bing, you know, learning how to play the power chords, you know, bing, 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 coon, coon, coon. That was my first gig, too, official performance, you know. Playing in the middle school dance, playing Smoke on the Water for about 2 hours. It's the truth. It is the truth. Somebody, oh, you started in the clubs? No, I started in the middle school. But anyway, and hold on, let's see, I can't get myself sidetracked here. Oh no, you can't. I gotta look at it. Hey, there we go. I'm still getting used to technology, you know. And before Hello, you heard Darn That Dream, not in 4/4, but in 3/4, for inquiring minds who wish to know. And we started out with a composition by Mother Chestnut's favorite composer, arranger in the whole world. Yes, she talks about this composer, arranger all the time. And the name of this composer, arranger, is Cyrus Chestnut. the composition was entitled Nippon Soul Connection. It actually will be on a recording coming up this year entitled My Father's Hands, done in tribute to my dad, who, time moves pretty fast. He passed away last May. And, you know, he left me with some beautiful gems. And one of the gems, I hope you don't mind if I just share with you, and I was just talking about it earlier. He said, son, I could have left you an inheritance of money and all, but so I felt that if I introduced you to music, music would take you longer than any money would. And so a very wise man. So here I am because of him. And so my father's hands. We don't want to overstay our welcome, you know. We hope that you all tell somebody and, you know, ask us to come back. We love the opportunity. Gentlemen, you must know, I probably tell you about set lists and everything, what's going to happen, and there's a 99.5% chance that it will not happen that way. And so, keeping up with tradition, here's the next piece. I have no idea what it is. I kind of have an idea. It's kind of like a teacher asking, well, I guess elementary school kids, I guess by the time you get to middle school, you're a little bit too cool to raise your hand, I suppose. For some of you, you might remember when teachers said, who would like to come up and give the answer, writing on the chalkboard, and all hands go up, you know. And some of the kids be so eager to do it, they would be basically standing up, coming to the board, me, you know, to get that opportunity. So in my mind, I'm asking, what's the next song? And all these songs are saying, me. And by talking and stalling, I'm not helping the situation. So in this case, what I'll probably do is, and a good advice to my own self, yes, I'm listening. Little Antonio is speaking to me. He says, "Hey, bro, get to it now." I'm going to place this microphone down and look at this Yamaha logo, and let's see what happens. It'll be something you know. At least I think so. Hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Stephen Gordon. Stephen Gordon on drums. Corcoran Holt on acoustic bass. Yours truly at the piano, Cyrus Chestnut. Thank you so very much.
Hey, everybody. Thanks for coming tonight. And this is a real honor for us. And 20 of you were here for the first show, so I can't do a repeat. I got to change my thing. But so I'll make it real brief. Just to say, please, if this is your first time here, welcome. And turn your phones off and don't take pictures. Just enjoy the music. And Michael Stewart made a comment, you know, before that you know you're in for some real stuff when you know a good third of the room is professional musicians in the area. So you know, that's a very cool thing, and it's a very cool thing that Cyrus Chestnut is here tonight, and we are really honored and so fortunate to have such cool people in the world. And thank all the donors for making this place possible, and all the musicians and the volunteers for working like crazy to make it happen. And enjoy the show, everybody. Thank you.
First set, I said, what you're about to hear is designed for the people in the first set. And so some people, and you get this question a lot, is the second set going to be the same as the first? Absolutely not. Even if we played the same tunes, it wouldn't be the same. But needless to say, this is going to be a whole different thing. So I can say again, what you're about to hear in this moment is designed for your ears and your ears only. We will not play this way for anyone else. And that is the truth, okay? I say this honestly. It is our intention to send you away feeling better than you arrived. We'll do everything that we can. However, if we don't make the mark, don't sue us, please. We can't afford it. So I guess while we're here, let me again introduce to you this master drummer, Mr. Stephen Gordon. Stephen Gordon. And this master bassist, Mr. Corcoran. And so I didn't say this in the first set. I kind of felt as if I got a little long-winded. You know, I have this, I always talk in I'm teaching in school, and I tell everybody about this voice, this inner voice. And I call my inner voice Little Antonio. And Little Antonio tapped me on the shoulder and said, "Say, bruh, play this tune. We have fights, you know? Say, bruh, play this tune." "No, I ain't playing this tune. Are you crazy?" "Bruh, trust me, you need to play this tune." In the first set, I was going on, and then here comes the tap. "See, bruh, you talking too long." People want to hear music. They don't want to hear you babble. And see, I'm starting to feel that again, so. Thank you for coming. Thank you for hanging out. We hope you enjoy yourselves.
Sometimes you do, but when you have the opportunity, yay! Sorry. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Gee, baby, ain't I good to you? Gee, baby, ain't I good to you? Thanksgiving, get it, yeah. Let's try it this way. Gee, baby, ain't I good to you? I'm going to leave it there. Now I know I kind of went to Sunday morning a little early, but you know it doesn't matter for me. You know, the church is the church, the building is just the building, but the church is here. Church is here, and any given time, at any given place, it can come out. And I'm not going to hold it back. Oh, I'm sorry. I am not going to hold it back. I do not feel it that way. I'd rather say, I ain't going to hold it back. That's how my uncle would say it, you know. Anyway, now let's go back. Let's go back and try to remember what was done here. Let's see, before that was the Gymnopedie, right?
Right, right.
Yeah, we went to Erik, Satie in his Gymnopedie, the first one. And before that, was that the Cubano Chant?
That was.
Okay.
You reminded me. I forgot.
Okay, yeah. Sometimes the moments are so very special, we have to remember, you know. That's what I say, it's right there in the moment, you know. Ray Bryant's Cubano Chant.
Nardis.
Oh, yeah, well, we did. No, that's right, we did Nardis. And then further back was the no. That's well. You see what we mean?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh no. I think I got it. This was just G Baby and I Good to You. Before G Baby and I Good to You was Nardis. Then was the Gymnopedie, and then backing up was Cubano Chant. And we started out with what? It's You or No One, Jules Stein. Oh, Lord, there was Baubles, Bangles, and Bees. That was actually number two. Yeah. We'll be here all night trying to sort it out. But the tunes are real. All right. So we hope that you are enjoying yourself some. Thank you, Dave, for letting us stop by and put some notes out into the atmosphere. And I'd like to thank each and every one of you all for supporting this beautiful establishment. We encourage you to tell somebody you like and tell somebody that you don't like. You know, there's education on the other side and some beautiful things, you know. Art is a beautiful thing, and you know, we are not all just number crunchers. You know, we do various different things, and any way that the younger generation can be encouraged to kind of find where they fit, you know, places as such help that. And so I'm thanking you in advance for all of your support. Thank you, donors, if you're here or wherever. I don't know if you're out there online, if it's streamed, I don't know. But just want to say thank you for everything. We don't want to overstay our welcome because we like to come back, and so, you know. And so we need your help. Tell somebody. Hopefully, next time we can be here a few days, and it could be standing room only. You know, so need your help. Okay, and so as I said earlier, the songs are screaming in my head, and by me stalling, it's not helping. So we're going to keep going on, and whatever the next piece is. And it will be a piece. I just can't go and just put something together in my head and expect them to they talk about me so bad, you know? I don't know. He just get that start playing whatever. We supposed to follow him? There's that voice tapping on my shoulder again. Yeah, you know, Sabre, come on, let's get to it. So we hope you enjoy what is about to come.
Thank you.
Sincerely about the moments. We work very hard to develop a language, develop a confidence, to develop a foundation. Okay, let's not get it twisted. We study rhythm, melody, and harmony, and how to communicate it to you. Just as if we were studying language, if we wanted to communicate with you our thoughts, then we have to study vocabulary and how to put vocabulary together to develop phrases and paragraphs and so on and so on. So we do that in the musical way, and that's what we spend our time doing. We constantly thinking. This improvisation game is a thinking person's game. It really is. You just don't play whatever. Some people might say you do that, but then, you know, what happens when you get out there and I've fallen and I can't get up? If you don't know how to grab a rope or something, or grab a branch to, you know, save yourself, you're falling. Anyway, it must be laid out. I don't usually talk this much. Thank you for coming. Thank you for your energy. And as I said earlier, it is our sincere desire that we send you away feeling better than when you arrived. And so hope we, and so as we bid you adieu, we ask that you take good care of yourselves, take care of each other. You know, we had a period of just tension and all. Let's release that tension. Let's spread some hope and some love around, you know. We certainly use that. And so until the next time, once again, on behalf of Stephen Corcoran, yours truly, Cyrus Chestnut, thank you so very much.